After studying the vital bleach technique, we come towards the non-vital tooth. What do you understand by the non-vital tooth? The teeth where the pulp chamber is involved or affected. So non-vital tooth bleaching. The first technique which we are going to study for the non-vital tooth bleaching is known as the walking bleach. So this technique was given by the scientists Nutting and Poe. Remember all the scientists? The agents which we are using for this technique is sodium perborate plus saline. Or the other thing which we can use is sodium perborate plus H2O2. Now, what are the protocols and procedure which we have to be following? The first one, since the pulp is already involved, the teeth should be root canal treated. That is, root canal treatment should be done in the teeth. After the root canal treatment has been done for the tooth, then you do is remove a gutta percha 1 to 2 mm apical to the cemento enamel junction. This is the second step of walking bleach. Then, after removing the gutta percha 1 to 2 mm apical to the cemento enamel junction, we need to place a barrier. Now, what is the requirement of the barrier? The main function of a barrier is it prevents the diffusion of the bleaching agent into the cervical region. So, this is the use why we are placing a barrier over the remaining gutta percha. The third most important point is most commonly used barrier that we are using is resin modified GIC. Remember, this is the barrier which we are using. And thickness for the barrier should be minimum of 2 mm. So you understood this? Removing a gutta percha, placing a barrier, then we come to apply the bleaching agent, that is sodium perborate, saline or water or H2O2 in the paste form is packed and it is inserted into the pulp chamber. After putting the bleaching agent in the paste form in the pulp chamber, seal the access with a temporary cement. Example of temporary cement is Cavit. It should be having a thickness of minimum 3 to 4 mm. The patient is then recalled after 1 week to reassess the procedure. So we'll see a diagram of all the steps which I explained for the walking bleach. So let's see the diagrammatic representation for the walking bleach technique. As I already mentioned, once the non-vital tooth is root canal treated, the second step is removing a gutta percha 1 to 2 mm apical to the cemento enamel junction. So this is the root filling or the gutta percha. Here you have removed the gutta percha and here it is replaced by a barrier. The most commonly used barrier is resin modified GIC. So this is resin modified GIC is here. It is about 2 mm in thickness. After the barrier is placed, then you can put your bleaching agent. So bleaching agent used in the walking bleach is sodium perborate plus saline, which is used in the form of paste. After the bleaching agent is kept, then it is the whole cavity sealed by the temporary cement like Cavit. And the thickness we require is 3 to 4 mm. This is how the non-vital tooth bleaching technique is done, and the technique's name is walking bleach. Let's see what are the adverse effects of this non-vital tooth bleaching technique, also known as walking bleach. The first and the most common here is the cervical root resorption. This is the adverse effect you will see in the non-vital tooth bleaching technique. The second is the failure to bond composite to the bleached tooth. So once the teeth is bleached, the teeth won't be able to bond with the composite. This complication needs to be handled because as residual H2O2 inhibits the polymerization of the composite. So bond strength restored is after 3 weeks. And if immediate composite is to be done, following are the options which you can do. If you require to do the composite immediately after the teeth is bleached. So these are the 3 points to be kept in mind, or 3 methods to prevent this or inhibiting of polymerization of composite. The first one is using 3% calculus solution for 3 minutes, which can neutralize the H2O2 and composite bonding can be done easily. This you can use. The second is using the alpha tocopherol. or you can use is alpha tocopherol. This also neutralizes H2O2 and composite bonding can be done. The third is using the plain sodium perborate either with saline or water and can be applied before composite bonding is done to neutralize the H2O2. So out of the three methods that we have to prevent the H2O2 inhibiting the polymerization of composite, the best one, this could be asked in the MCQ, very important for the exams, is the best method to bind the composite and the tooth is using sodium perborate with saline or water. This is the best method out of the three available options we have. The other frequently asked question is, in the walking bleach technique, what happens? The options, it uses a heat treatment. No, this is the property of thermocatalytic technique. Walking bleach is a non-vital technique, if you remember from the lecture. Heat treatment we are using in the case of non-vital technique only, but that is thermocatalytic technique. So it requires a patient to report in 24 hours? No, it's a non-vital technique. It can be done within 35% of H2O2? No, because hydrogen peroxide is not used as a bleaching agent for the non-vital technique. It uses a mixture of sodium perborate and hydrogen peroxide. So here sodium perborate plays an important role in the non-vital technique. So this is the closest or the right answer for the question. In the walking bleach technique, we use a mixture of sodium perborate and hydrogen peroxide. So the answer is D.